Oh, Just a city boy, himself to trust. He took the midnight train going anywhere.
It's missing, it's the time that I spend alone, sailing on the cool and bright clear water. There's lots of those friendly people, they're showing me ways to go, but I never want to lose their inspiration. It's time for a cool change. And now that my life is so prearranged, I know that it's time for a cool change. Well, I was born in the sign of water, and it's there that I feel
Capital News Service for Monday, June 8th, 1992, with Dasha Parrott, Brian Vandeveer, and Sandra Leon.
This year was filled with many great memories. Here's a look at homecoming highlights from last fall.
And friends are friends forever. In the Father's hands we know that a lifetime's not too long to live as friends. And with the faith and love God's given, springing from the hope we know, joy you'll live in is the strength that now you should.
Fall and winter seem so far away. Let's take a look at some of our favorite commercials from this past fall and winter trimester.
I'll save you. Trust me. coming. Trust me. Angel, homecoming. Trust me.
Jeff,
Angela,
wake up.
Trust me. Trust.
Movie's over.
Will you go to homecoming with me?
Yes, I will.
This is Laura Miller with CNS, and here's John DeVoy just in from his last throw. It was a remarkable performance, John.
Thanks a lot. You know, it's really hard. I just put my heart into it, and I got the aerodynamics lined up perfect on the dart, and, you know, I think I did one of my best throws of my entire career.
And how do you feel after this?
You know, I feel a bit pooped, but, you know, it usually starts out, I get this lawn dart high. You know, it's something, you know, only a lawn dart thrower would know, but, you know, it's just this extra burst of energy. Only you lawn dart players out there know what I'm talking about.
Here's Gabe Rutledge at the last ring, aiming, about ready to hit. Oh, yes. Look at the joy in his face. He's won this game.
That was one of Gabe Rutledge's typical shots on the croquet field. Here's Gabe now. Gabe, how do you manage to master your croquet skills with such an academically challenging schedule?
Well, Jill, it's a matter of priorities. A lot of people feel academics is important, but throw money is in this mallet right here.
And what do you have planned for the future?
Well, I take a lot of PE.
I'm John DeVoy, and we're with Super One Lars Knutsen just after the race. Lars, how do you feel?
Well, you know, I've been doing this for 2.5 years, but, I mean, it's tough because these days there's a lot of competition, if you know what I mean.
Throughout the years, the class of 1992 has grown and changed. Now here's a look at some of our seniors as fifth graders.
Hi, my name's Megan Young, and I had a good year. One of my best favorite things was outdoor school, and I'm looking forward to the summer.
Hi, my name is Brenda Bailey, and I like doing gymnastics, and I also like to eat, and I'm looking forward to going to Jefferson next year.
My name is Sarah Simon, and I am in Mrs. Bell's class. I come from California and Washington State.
My name is Melissa Erickson. This is the best year that I have had at LP Brown. My hobby is listening to music.
My name is Jelmani Kuko, and my favorite part of this year was going to outdoor school at CISPUS, and Mr. Hughes is really funny.
My name is Janine Lasamoto. I'm 11 years old, and I like to do sports like swimming and soccer.
Hello, my name is Amy Borden, and I'm 11 years old. I have enjoyed fifth grade a lot.
My favorite part was going to CISPUS. I enjoy doing after-school sports, soccer, and ballet.
Hi, my name is Chip Reese. I'm in Mr. Hughes' class at LP Brown School. I enjoy a wide variety of sports. Some of my favorites are baseball and skiing.
Hi, my name is Tim Rogers. I enjoy playing sports. One of my favorite is soccer.
My name is Danny Taylor. I like to play soccer and enjoy many different board games.
My name is Susie DuPont, and my favorite animals are monkeys, pigs, and cows.
I'm Amy Hartpell, and I really enjoy fifth grade, but I'm looking forward to summer vacation.
My name is Jennifer Childs, and I've enjoyed fifth grade, my teacher, Mr. Hughes, and I can't wait for some summer to come so I can go crazy.
My name is Erin Williams, and I've really enjoyed this year and my teacher, Mr. Hughes. I can't wait for summer vacation to start.
My name is Brooke Rogers, and right now I'm really enjoying fifth grade at LP Brown. My teacher is Mr. Hughes, and he's really a good teacher. I'm looking forward to summer vacation.
My name is Brian Vanderveer. I like to do football, basketball, baseball, and soccer.
Once again this year, the Capital sports teams have done well. From the exciting winning football season to the state championship in boys tennis, the year has been great. Here's some highlights from this past year.
A time when seniors anxiously begin to await graduation. Now here's a look at our favorite spring commercials.
You look great.
Tell me about it, Stead.
Will you go to prom with me?
Of course I will.
Bukowski's winning throw, and the all-important urinal flushing celebration when the U.S. clinched the gold. It was a thing of beauty.
Hey, Mr. Fanono!
Everybody down! Get back! Get back!
And now let us look back at the memories and relive the past year for just a moment.
See you in 10.
Bye! Bye.
People touch and they're gone. Good evening. This is my last time to chance, or last time for my chance, excuse me. This is my last time to talk to all of you, so I took a few notes here on what I wanted to say to you guys. I haven't practiced it yet, so I hope you guys all bear with me. To be honest with you, I had a lot of trouble writing this speech. I've written 4 speeches so far, and this is the last one I've written, so that's what I'm going to give to you. As a student speaker, I'm supposed to sum up these last 4 years in a way that'll make you kind of happy and make you remember it for a while. And what am I supposed to say to you guys? I mean, it's been great these last 4 years, or the world is yours. Well, that would sound like another boring graduation speech, and that's not what I wanted to give to you guys. By the same token, you know, I couldn't sit up here and tell you Laffy Taffy jokes, because the administration wouldn't like that. But if things break down, I have my collection of 3,371 Laffy Taffy jokes up here. We could dig through those if we need to, so. But anyways, I chose instead to talk about one of our classmates, someone that really epitomizes these last 4 years at Capitol High School. I'm pretty sure that you all know him by now. He's the brother of Fred Berfel and second cousin, twice removed, of Kurt Westheimer. Some of you might not know that. He's never been to class, but yet he graduates with us tonight. Of course, I'm talking about John Fanono. I thought that right now would be the perfect time to honor him and tell about his birth, because I think it's kind of an interesting story. And I might embarrass a couple members of our class, but that's no big deal. He is the imaginary childhood friend of another one of our classmates. Needing a sports partner when his brothers were busy, Tim Rogers created John Fanono. So whenever his brothers were busy, he'd have someone to play baseball with and someone to play football with. In middle school, Dan Taylor found out about John Fanono, and John began his rise to fame. One day, walking up from band, Tim and Dan spied the freshman presidential sign-up list by the ASB. Needless to say, I think we all know what happened that day. John Fanono began his political career. People couldn't quite figure out who he was or where he came from, whether he was from Jefferson or from Griffin or if he'd moved out of state. The day finally rolled around when we had the graduation speeches, that's today. 4 years ago, we had the election speeches. And by accident, John Fanono wasn't there because he was feeling ill, but Dan had prepared a speech to give on his behalf. Unfortunately, that was rejected and we couldn't vote for someone who wasn't present. Since then, John Fanono has run for numerous class positions. He's been very vocal in some of our school productions and nearly been killed by a crazed assassin. Other classes have tried to imitate him, but John Fanono was the first and the best. He is not the property of any other class, not 91, not 93, not 94. I forgot 95 on purpose. He is 100% 92. He will no longer run for freshman class president or any other office of student government, nor will he sign up for any committees or work parties. His days at Capitol are through. Tonight he graduates with us, number 263. He will graduate last, following us everywhere like he has for the last 4 years. John Fanono has taught us how to laugh. That is the most important thing that you could have learned here at Capitol High School. Physics formulas and biology phylums are not going to do you any good if you stress out, go crazy, and throw yourself off a bridge. The most important lessons that you have learned here at Capitol have not been in a classroom. They've been with your friends, the people that are sitting around you now. You have learned how to laugh, how to make friends, how to work with other people, how to interact socially, how to drive a car, some of you, with, or in some cases, how to not deal with members of the opposite sex. These are things that you will never forget. This is the last time that we will ever be together, all of us. Not all of us will make it to the 10-year reunion. Not all of us might make it through tonight if I keep talking any longer. So I leave you with the doctor's last advice. It's kind of a personal philosophy of mine. Do not worry about things that you cannot control. Instead, spend your time enjoying life. Remember to laugh, and don't forget how to have fun. And don't forget your classmates. Don't forget to write. The class of 92 has been the best class in Capitol's history. Never forget that your classmates will be there for you. Take the memories and friendship that you have developed here, wherever you go, for the rest of your life. I wish you all the best of luck. Thank you very much. Good evening. Perhaps I should say that again. Good evening. That's better. I really like to speak where I feel welcomed, so thank you. I realize that most of you are probably very hot right now, and perhaps maybe even a little bit tired,
and perhaps even somewhat hungry. And worst of all, your posterior isn't exactly feeling like a million bucks either. And also realize that a lot of you think that a graduation speech is your ticket to nap time. Well, that's all right, you know, I understand what you mean, because I feel the same way. You see, it's been proven that graduation speeches are a great cure for sleeping disorders. But tonight, things will be different. You see, tonight, you as an audience will actually get a chance to participate in my speech. But that's not all. You can even win a reward for your participation. Sounds too good to be true, huh? Well, it's not. And here's how it works. We're going to play a little game that's similar to Wheels of Fortune, or Wheel of Fortune. I'm sure you all like that game. If you notice, there are 16 letter cards up there. And each letter card, of course, has a letter on it. And what you need to do is, each letter stands for a word beginning with that letter. And I will tell you what it is. And what you need to do is write them all down. That's as simple as that. And at the end of the ceremony, if you come to me and you have all this written down, I give you a prize. Easy, huh? It's easier to win this than the lottery, I guarantee you. Okay. Now, once the letter is all revealed, there's going to be a magic word that's going to appear. So pay attention. Now, the secret of this game is your listening skill. So if you decide to snooze, you will lose. Okay, it's simple as that. All right, first of all, I should tell you there's a hyphen in this phrase. Okay, there's a hyphen. It's kind of bent right now, but that's okay. He'll fix it. That's a Vanna White up there. Give him a hand. Actually, it's not Vanna White, it's John Ank, but he's a capitalist version of Vanna White. I think he's better looking, too. Okay. The first letter in our phrase is a C. All right? There he goes, C. Now, C stands for commencement. What else? I'm sorry, it stands for commencement. I make the rules. Okay? Now, after tonight, we in the class of 92 enter a new phase in our lives. As a matter of fact, a major part of our lives really begins because high school was merely a preparation for adulthood and the responsibilities that come with it. So class, now listen carefully, class. If the high school part of your life was, well, pretty much a big stinker, realize that you have a chance to make the next part of your life as best as you want it to be. Okay, that was a little deep, but you know, it's true. Our next letter is an E. E stands for ethics. During the last few years, we've been disgusted to see the lack of ethical and moral standards in our country. We get angry at all the scandalous actions of our government, and we shake our heads at the Rodney King situation. Well, it may be a cliche, class, but the best way to change what is wrong is to do what is right. Amen? All right. Class, we can be the generation that reverses the flow of the decline of morality in our country. It all starts with you as an individual. Do you want to make a difference by setting high moral and ethical standards in your life? Or are you willing to go with the flow and blend in with the rest of society? I dare you to make a difference. Our next letter is an N. N stands for not. N-O-T exclamation mark, not. Now, throughout our 4 years of high school, perhaps no other word has been used more than this one. Here's an example of how it's used in most cases. Commencement ceremonies are very exciting. Not. That's how it's used in most cases. Okay, moving right along, our next letter is a T. T stands for together. Now, write that down, together. You've heard it before, and you hear it again, and you already heard it once tonight from Jeff. Do you realize, class, that tonight will be the last time we'll be together as a group? I know, it's quite sad, but it's true. I just had to say it, because what's a commencement ceremony without saying that twice? And I just done that. Okay, our next letter is an S. S stands for scared. Scared. Undoubtedly, it's one of the emotions we all have at this moment, whether we want to admit it or not. We're scared because we're uncertain about our future. Things like college, career, marriage, etc., etc., etc. You know, but fear, listen carefully, fear doesn't have to be a negative thing, because it can and often does bring out the best in all of us. I challenge you to use your fear to bring out the best in all of you. A is our next letter. A stands for answers. I imagine a lot of you in the class of 92 are searching for answers. Of course, there are some of us who don't even know the questions. Regardless, we are searching for answers concerning our present and future plans, our goals in life, our college and work experience, and whether tonight's senior class trip will be any fun. That's S. W is our next letter. W stands for work. As you know, this past year, Americans were criticized of being lazy and having bad work ethic. Now, whether we agree with that or not, it certainly should wake us up and get us a little pumped up. Isn't that so? Well, it should be. And as we prepare to go into the work field class, challenge yourselves to work harder than any of your parents or anyone before you. Let's be the generation that receives praises for our work ethic and integrity from the rest of the world. Moving right along, we come to the letter O. O stands for Oreo cookies. Can you imagine how many Oreo cookies you've eaten since kindergarten? It's kind of a scary thought, isn't it? Our next letter is L. Some of you want to solve the puzzle, but you can't yet. L stands for love, L-O-V-E, love. There's no doubt that the world needs a lot more of this. Just ask the residents of Los Angeles. There are many definitions of love, and unfortunately, too many high schoolers define it as something one practices in the backseat of a car, if you know what I mean. But there's a definition of real love. This definition comes from a very reliable source. As a matter of fact, it is the only absolute source which will give you all the answers to life's questions. This definition of L-O-V-E comes from the B-I-B-L-E. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It is not rude. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Take notes on this, it's very valuable. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices in the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. You know, class, the world is hurting for that type of love. And we can turn the world upside down if each and every one of us commits to serve others instead of being so much of ourselves like society wants us to be. N is our next letter. N is for Norwood, as in Mr. Norwood. And I have to hand it to you, Mr. Norwood. You certainly picked the right class to come out with. And I'm glad you waited until this year to come out, because I cannot imagine Capitol High School without Mr. Norwood. Don't you agree, class? I thought you would. Speaking of Mr. Norwood, I, our next letter, stands for intelligent. You know, that's a pretty good description of our class, don't you think? The fact is, each and every one of us are blessed with a certain amount of intelligence. Mankind's ability to distinguish, reason, decide, separates us from other species on Earth. So as we go on our separate ways in the world, we won't have mom or dad to pamper or make decisions for us. We have to do it for ourselves. That's what independence is all about. And we don't have to let society dictate our decisions either. God gave us a brain to think for ourselves, and we need to use it. And believe it or not, we can even abstain from certain things, if you know what I mean. Our next letter is a T. T, here comes Vanna. Thanks, Vanna. T stands for time. For those of you who are wondering, it is about 7:14 right now, and I only have a couple minutes left in my speech, so hang in there. S is our next letter. S is for stories. Can you imagine all the stories we'll have 5, 10, 15, 20, 50 years from tonight? We'll be saying things like, remember our freshman skit? Or remember how great everyone looked during disco day? Not. And remember when our football team crushed only 24-0 to bring home the golden ball? Yeah, I thought you'd remember that. And remember that goofy looking guy who gave that weird graduation speech? I'm talking about you, Hogan. Oh, so many stories we'll have to tell to our kids and grandkids. Why is for yesterday. I'm sure we'll all wake up tomorrow thinking to ourselves, wow, yesterday I was a high school student, today I'm not. Then we'll all feel like a part of us is somehow missing. But don't worry, I'm sure we'll all get over it just fine. F is our next letter. Actually, you know, that O should be up because, well, I have one more letter after F, but that's all right. Now you know the phrase. F is our next letter. F is for F forever. That's how long the last few weeks of school seemed to last. But it did get over, and graduation has finally arrived. For those of you who are wondering, you are at a graduation ceremony. And now that it's here, class, don't do anything stupid to ruin your celebration. In other words, stay sober. And finally, we come to the moment you've all been waiting for, the conclusion of my speech. The last letter in our word game has already been exposed. It's an O, which stands for original. And when it comes down to it, that's what makes the class of 92 special. We are an original. No other class before or after us is like us. So take pride in that, class, and realize that you are an original, and in no way do you have to conform to society's standards. Well, congratulations, you made it through another graduation speech. Now, if you wrote down all the letters and what they stand for, come see me after graduation, I have a nice gift for you. Thanks.
Thank you. Really proud of you guys. You look great coming in. Made me proud. Thank you. As Bo said, every class has its own personality. This one's unique. How would I know 18 years ago when we were building Capitol High School and you were just being born that when you left Capitol, so would I. And I'm proud to be a part of your class. Thanks, Bo and Jeff, Shauna, those who are going to follow, Sarah, Chris, Jill, and Velvet. Thanks for the entertainment. You represent your class well. I'd like to say a few things about this class before I present the scholarships. They're not the biggest class we've had go through here, but quality comes in small packages. We have 62, that's 62 students in this class who have a 3.5 GPA or above. The top 10%, including the two top students, are only received, those top two students received only one A minus during the 4 years that they were here. Would the top 10 please stand up? Academic top 10. And the academic top 20, the top 20 stand. Thank you. And we have five National Merit Scholars in this class. Most schools are lucky to get one. We have five. That means they're in the top one-half of 1% in the nation. Will the five National Merit Finalists, will you stand, please, be recognized? We also have four students who are commended. That means they're in the top 5% in the nation. Would they stand? This class has really done well in academic competition. Third in the state in the Knowledge Bowl. Knowledge Bowl team, you people are on Knowledge Bowl. Math team, academic decathlon, won first in the state. Represented the state of Washington in the nationals. Debate, drama. Would you please stand if you were a Knowledge Bowl, math team, academic decathlon, debate, or drama? We have so many people involved in athletics as well as academics, in leadership positions, in those things that I just mentioned, like drama, all kinds of activities. This class, and I think this has got to be a record, these students earned 367 varsity letters in athletics while they were in school. We had 51 of these students named to All-Conference Black Hills League, and there were 75 of these people who were involved in state-level competition. That's got to be a record. Congratulations. And rather than have all those who were involved with athletics stand, I want one person to stand who really represented our school the way we like, not you, Ken, sorry, the way we hope our athletics will. She's competitive, she's fair, she trains, she earned 14 varsity letters, 14 varsity letters while she was at Capitol High School. Her name is Sarah Dickey. Will you stand, Sarah? Congratulations. I also have a couple people, or three people I'd like to stand. One of the things that makes you successful either in school or on the job is being there every day. We have three students who have perfect attendance for 4 years. Would you three students stand up if you really had perfect attendance? I could go on and on about this class because there's really some terrific people in it. I have to mention Siri Engstrom. Siri's the yearbook editor, and Mr. Eby and I both agree that's the best yearbook we've ever had, Siri. Will you take a bow? And how about a guy like Terry Kissick, who on his day off from school yesterday saved a man's life by pulling him out of the lake. He actually saved this guy. He was 74. He was drowning. I'd like to close my comments about the class of 92 by having two people stand up who I hope will be an example for all of you, and that is to have recognition for service above self. It's someone who works behind the scenes to do good deeds for other people, and they won the Service Above Self Award this year, Greg Hazelrig and Christy Bryant. Will you stand? Now, this is the fun part. If you look on your program, you'll see an awful lot of scholarships. But I have some here that are complete surprises for students. And I'd like to have those students come forward now. And if my two vice principals, Mr. Douglas Hay, Mr. John Seeley, if you'll step forward and help me out here. The first one goes to Christy Brandt. It's a $400 Coca-Cola scholarship. Christy, come forward, please. Amy Borden, $300 from the Roland and Sue Upton Pemco Foundation Scholarship. Aaron Fairbrook won the Bob Swanberg Memorial. $500 to David Walker, the Irving A. Lassen Foundation. To Melissa Van Meegum, the Irving A. Lassen Foundation, $500. The Tim Crow Memorial Award, part of the Capitol High Foundation, goes to Jill Monacucco. The Derek Scott Miller Memorial, $1,000, Josh Pratt. From our music support group, the Champs, $350 to Laura Ramsey. The Richard D. Hunter Educational Scholarship goes to Jenny Roeder. The Delta Kappa Gamma Educational Scholarship to Shauna Simmons. The Esther Knox Award to Amy Eisenhart. Lumberman's Vocational Scholarship, Bonnie Smith. Ellen E. Bodling Pepsi Scholarship, $450 to Hop 2. Olympia Education Association, $350 to Laura White. Also, the Olympia Education, $350 to Brian Vandiver. Olympia Tumwater Foundation, $1,500, Shauna Rowe. And this one from the Champs, another $350 to Shauna Rowe. Josh Diekman, Olympia Tumwater Foundation, $3,500. $500 from the Twin County Credit Union goes to Dale Woodnut. And from the West Olympia Rotary, $300 to Dale Woodnut. West Olympia Rotary, $300 to Siri Engstrom. West Olympia Rotary, $300 to Kimberly Chan. West Olympia Rotary, $300 to Minna Kang. $200 to Spencer Kimmel. West Olympia Rotary, $300 to Sandra Leone. West Olympia Rotary, $300 to Brooke Rogers. West Olympia Rotary Outstanding Student, $1,000, Stephanie Bird. Brian Fredrickson, $500, Olympia Host Lions. $350 to Laura Miller from Chapter CF of PEO. Laura? Two years of free tuition to South Puget Sound goes to Adrian Corbin. Chapter Y of PEO, $325 to Janine Masamoto. And the Jim Caldwell Memorial Scholarship, $250, goes to Jill Miller. Olympia Educational Office Professional to Buffy Larson. Chapter F of PEO goes to Amy Carpell, $200. Dan Sheldon Memorial, part of the Capitol High Foundation, goes $500, goes to Tim Johnson. And the last one is special to me. It's the first Larry Norwood Scholarship made possible by the Capitol High Foundation and your generous gifts to the foundation in recognition of my retirement. And that first one, it's $500. It goes to Shannon Hurst. Now, I think this next musical number is very appropriate.
Packing up the dreams God planted in the fertile soil of you. Can't believe the hopes he's granted means a chapter in your life. We'll keep too long to live as friends. With the faith and love God's given, springing from the hope we know, we will pray the joy you'll live in is the strength that now you show. We'll keep you close.
Introduce Dr. Al Cohen, Superintendent of Schools for the Olympia School District.
What a wonderful song and performed so well. Thank you. I too would like to extend my greetings to our soon-to-be graduates, their parents, family members, and friends. We're all proud of you. On behalf of the entire school district staff, and especially those staff members who know and have worked with you over the years, we offer our congratulations for your accomplishments. Your deeds bring a tremendous amount of pleasure to us and serve as an energy boost as we renew our efforts to work with future classes. The time you've been waiting for. At this time, I certify to the members of the Olympia School District Board of Directors that these students seated before you, the class of 1992 from Capitol High School, have met the graduation requirements as established by the Washington State Legislature, the State Board of Education, and those additional requirements established by the Olympia School District Board of Directors. President Bigelow, it is indeed a privilege to present to you the class of 1992 from Capitol High School.
Thank you, Superintendent Cohen. The first thing I'd like to do, since the Olympia School District services the Griffin School District, we have on the podium with us tonight Sue Mack from the Griffin School Board. Sue? As president of the Olympia School Board, it's my privilege to welcome you, the graduating class of 1992. Your parents, relatives, friends, the school staff, and fellow citizens have come to honor you tonight. Together you share in the accomplishment the diploma that we will present to you tonight represents. We hope that you will appreciate everything that's gone into this. Many people have helped you along the way. Your parents, your teachers, the school district staff, hundreds of volunteers in the Olympia District, and yes, don't forget, the taxpayers in our community and the state of Washington. All of them have shared in your education and your future. Tonight, though you're not just celebrating the completion of your education, you're celebrating the beginning of a new period in your life. And all of us from the Olympia School Board wish you well in your chosen endeavors. We accept your class for graduation and recognize that it has fulfilled the requirements of the state of Washington and the Olympia School District. Therefore, we extend to all of you our best wishes and congratulations. Thank you.
Would ask your indulgence at the end of the ceremony, please, parents and friends, allow the students enough time to exit on a recessional. Last year we got mobbed. They couldn't get out. Let them get out and we'll join them. They promised to wait in the back for us. The first two rows will be presented by Barbara Roeder. First graduate, Brian Jeffrey Lemon. John Eason St. John. John Easton DeVoy. Gabriel Antelope Rutledge. Kenneth Dean Robinson. Christina Lee Shelton. Christine A. Strathdy. Maggie Jean Vale. Angela Jolene Dyer. Janie Gail Roeder. Brian D. Christensen. Jennifer Christine Easley. Nicole Nanette Eckhart. Buffy Melissa Larson. Jennifer Ann Doyle. Susanna Marie DuPont. Laura Mary White. Andrea Dawn Stevenson. Joseph Majoric Laverne III. Brian Frederick Harrison. David Ian Walker. Eric Stewart Downer. Jennifer Lynn O'Neill. Hai Quang. Juan Carlos Miltenberger Rodriguez. John Leonard Brodham IV. Sakun Cho. Lorenda Lee Cody. Natalie Lee Merritt. Amy Ann Carpell. Janine Maiko Masamoto. Cheryl Ann Dial. Angela Jean Grison. Kimberly Ming Yi Chan. Sandra Eliana Leon. Laura Victoria Ramsey. Lon Kong Tran. Don Tran Qua. Felice Victoria Rowe. Claire Louise Beeler. Sarah Jane Dickey. Heidi Lynn Oletsky. Greg Allen Hazelrig. Todd Alexander Daly. Lars Everett Knudsen. Howard Emil Barlow. John Gabriel Stewart. Matthew Evan Dreisbach. Keith David Wilcox. The next two rows will be presented by Board Member Mary Farrington. Barry George Mulock. Shauna Elizabeth Rowe. Sarah Elizabeth Corey. Aaron Lee Smith. Shauna Krista Simmons. Mary Beth Diane Padgett. Melissa Denise Erickson. Jennifer Siri Childs. Teresa Lynn Stalkup. Shelley Joyce Chapman. Kimberly Joe Paulson. Melanie Maureen Earhart. Michelle Lynn White. Stephen James Heyman. Michelle Renee Miller. Libby R. Downer. Timothy Palmer Johnson. Brian Paul Fredrickson. Rosa Ching. Debbie Ching. Kenji Israel Sugiyama. Jill Christine Miller. Jill Suzanne Hermes. Jennifer Diane Newman. Lee Jennifer Brazil. Jennifer Michelle Salino. Catherine Elizabeth Baer. Jennifer Eileen Wells. Melissa Lynn Van Meegum. Christy Lynn Brandt. Timothy Benjamin Rogers. Brian Scott Vandenberg. Young C. Dang. Fu Vu. Stephen Michael Riley. Amon Othello Johnson. Kristen Marie Tradewell. Dasha Marie Parrott. Colette Renee Woodard. Kara Jill Flatley. Angela Marie Piercy. Amy Colleen Eisenhart. Sarah Lynn Falter. Jill Marion Monacuco. Tish Adette Zink. Tracy Marie Osterberg. Nina Kang. Sadith Manathkoff. Robert A. Page. The next two rows will be presented by board member Chris Hedrick. Megan Ann Cornwall. Robin Elizabeth Hipp. Jessica Allison Austin. Rebecca Victoria Snow. Justin Max Hayes. David Charles Kretschmer. Daniel James Taylor. Christopher Trong Nguyen. Owen Glendwer Reese. John Michael Smith. Tan Phu Nguyen. Paul Anthony Strophy. Lisa Kathleen Reed. Michael Gordon Westfall. Terry Allen Kissick. Craig Edward Lasley. Spencer Lynn Kimmel. Michael Sean Rickert. Aaron James Fairbrook. Jeffrey Allen Hogan. Siri Engstrom. Amy Marie Borden. Laura Lee Miller. Christine Denise Langill. Dawn Lynn Smith. Teresa Lynn Baldwin. Michelle Desiree Steer. Lisa Marie Meeban. Amy Elaine Collins. Stephanie Myra Bird. Carla Rose Gore. Krista Renee Fricke. Shannon Kathleen Hurst. Megan Wynier Young. Brooke Ann Rogers. Dale Ann Woodnett. Sean Oren Lemon. James Donald Bryant. Young Ka Tang. Jeremy Scott Watson. Deirdre Alta Geddes. Erin Elizabeth Williams. Elizabeth Amelia Jones. Valerie Michelle Humphreys. Christy Laurie Foster. Jennifer Annette Bull. Jerry Dale Wyatt. Bob Carionis. The next two rows will be presented by board member John Keith, Peter Justin Hines, Kyle Patrick Grendel, Brenda Elizabeth Bailey, Deborah Francis McMillan, Jeffrey Lee Irons, George Allen Steerer, Shane Bird, James Gordon Christensen, Hawk Wynn Two, Sean Curtis Sudum, Bo Rothy Hoy, Rodney Brett Downey, Jocelyn Ann Watson, Christina H. Knetzer, Jody Lynn Pitts, Brandon James Murray, Jennifer Lynn Boone, Alexis Laura Lynn, Paige Elise Sauerman, Margaret Rose White, Jennifer Joyce Cooper, will you please not blow the air horn? Thank you. Justin Anthony Akins. Nicholas Engdahl. Amelda Real Ang. Adrian Beth Corbin. Tanya Ray Kelly. Brandy Allison Moore. Kirsten Lee Anders. Na Mao. Jeffrey Michael Corbin. Tina Marie Murphy. Bonnie Lynn Smith. Albert Soup Na. Perry Martin Hanchey Jr. Brian David Waltz. Jason Philip Feltes. Michael James Fox. Stephen Matthew Brenner. Anthony Michael Kolb. Matthew Scott Campbell. James Heffley. Michael Aho. Joshua Matthew Pratt. Matthew John Morton. Teen Ho. Hong Van Tai Nguyen. The rest of the graduates will be introduced by Mr. Robert Bigelow, Chairman of the Board. Aaron Matthew Jupp. Hagen Wagner. Laura Aldama Urita. Miriam Lutoff. Hinata Toledo Fontes. Luciana Zantin Santos. Malin Susanna Jacobson. Maureen Julian Kuhn. Wee Jung J. Chin. Danelia Hotschmidt. Angie Weimert. John Garvin Tunison. Thaddeus Roy Elwin Brown. Chang Che. Weil Bryson Cordes. Joshua James Diekman. Tong V. Lee. V. Tai Ho. Trong Yong Lu. Tu Tan Nguyen. Lan Bin Ngoc Ho. Phong Ta Lam. Savit Ta Lam. Nia Wang Lu. Angela E. Kinkella. Tad Lee Wilhelm. Robert C. Volsky. Jennifer J. Kagg. Heidi Melissa Holman. Kobe Ryan Magoon. Matthew Kyle Iverson. Lee Min Nguyen. Michael James Peters III. Earl H. Lynn. Devin Gerald Geisler. Julian Teske. Joel Clayton Moore. Russell John Morse. Brian Wayne Lemaster. Anthony Hartlow. Catherine M. Manker. Kamison Vongdara. Hang Che. David A. Edwards. Myra Lee Reams. Danielle Renee Parshell. Michael David Newline. William Jeffrey Ritchie. Kenton J. A. Jensen. Aisha Akbar Nayani. Lee Matthias Herman. Miles Victor DeLafayette Sargent. Cyrus Charles Amon. William Stewart Vance. Rachel Jennifer Sweet. Michael J. Vesey. Jason Christopher Scheibel. Robert Maynard Jean. John A. Conine. John Frederick Sager. Dolly Lynn Drake. Amy Lee Felber. Velvet Marie Newcomb. Daniel Jason Bartlett. Joseph Damian Naxted. Craig Gary Westling. John Patrick Eberly. This is the senior class president, Sarah Corey.
Before we do the tassel ceremony, I'd like that Mr. Norton could please step forward. As all of you know, this is Mr. Norton's last year at Capital High School. And in memory of the many years you have dedicated to our student body, as well as our class, and in honor of your retirement this year, the class of 1992 would like to express our sincere thanks by donating $500 to the Larry Norwood Scholarship Fund. Wonderful 4 years here, and I'm going to miss all of you. Congratulations on all your achievements, and good luck in the future. We're graduating.